morning, I was just me, but it seemed a little toasty. Didn't know if it was my menopause here. So, I'm happy to report that we've been awarded another grant, from the CJCC. It's in the amount of $132,193. It's gonna require a 12% match this year instead of the 10%. That comes to $18,026, bringing it up to $150,219. We are asking for some additional money to the day funds, so that we can fund the surveillance officer. The grant will be provided, I think, for about a half a year. We also need the money for the reconnect call-in for the drug alcohol testing. And we like to use some of the money as well to offset the treatment costs that participants have to pay, making it more, amenable for them to enter the program. So, we're asking for an additional $24,469 from the day funds. I'm happy to report that there is sufficient funding, there's actually more than that from the state board, what the state board generated. So, we're asking for a total, as I understand, of $42,495. I did ask, Ms. Harris is the new coordinator, to reach out to the council and court judges to see if they could prepare some type of cost-saving analysis for each of you, so you can determine and see that this program is supposed to be saving you money. So she's gonna hand that to you. This is what was prepared by them. We actually received it in the last way drop, I was gonna attach it. So that's based on the information that the coordinator has to enter in about our program. They, I understand, looked at the incarceration rate, multiplied by that, took out the program costs, and then gave you like a cost-saving amount for each dollar that you put in. We'd ask that you continue to fund this program. All of these studies show that it helps. Please remember that this program is not for your average DUI. It is for repeat offenders, which is approximately one-third of your DUI offenders. I will tell you, we've had 58 graduate from the program. We've got four we anticipate graduating on July 15th. We're approximately 28 participants at this time. We've grown to about 30. We have touched more than that, though. We do have people that enter the program that sometimes they just have to go on the residential treatment or don't make it through the program. So we've touched about 200 people since January 17th. These are all residents here of Lowndes County. We'd ask that you continue to fund this program. It does fund a part-time case manager. That case manager would actually help enter, as I understand, data that we are required to enter from the program, meet with participants. I've already talked with Ms. Roundtree. She was very excited about this prospect. As that person, she said she could locate an office for them to use when the participants have to meet with probation, and they'll help with actual drug and alcohol testing. So,